Hi, I'm Sherry Wagner, and welcome back to Behind the Scenes at New York One. I have with me today Roma Torre, anchor and reporter here at New York One News. Roma, I'd like to let our subscribers out there know a little bit more about your job and what you do here.
Well, I do a lot of everything here at New York One. I anchor on weekends, Friday nights and Saturday nights. That sounds strange because weekends at New York One encompasses Friday nights through Sunday afternoons. The A-team, in a sense, takes over with Lewis Dodley on the weekend nights, Sunday nights, and he works Sunday nights through Thursday evening. Mm-hmm. Besides that, I'm a reporter, and I happen to have fallen into a strange specialty, travel. I'm not a traveler by trade, but I was assigned the job, and so I do travel stories, which is kind of fun. I'm also doing theater reviews now, which is plays on my background as an actress way back when. So I'm kind of a jack of all trades here.
I'd like to hear a little bit about each one. The travel pieces are a lot of fun. That must be a nice break from the hard news that you also cover.
Well, I have to burst the bubble of some folks out there who think that I am here and there and everywhere. I don't go to Tahiti, as a rule, and I don't go to Egypt or Mexico or any of those exotic places. When you see a travel piece from Coney Island, you may believe I was really there. But with that as the exception, I really am not able to get out. So we rely on the News Travel Network, which supplies videotapes of these places. And I look at the tapes and I write stories based on the pictures that they provide and the information that they send over.
Well, they're put together well, New York One style, with the different graphics and the traveling planes. It must be nice teamwork here.
Well, there's a lot of care that goes into these. You know, we have a wonderful, as you mentioned, this graphic. It's a we labored hard to put this together. It was sort of an animated airplane that looks like something out of Raiders of the Lost Ark, which is kind of a fun effect. But we try to localize it as much as possible.
Okay, curious, first of all, what your day is like at New York One?
It's like four jobs in one, and it's actually a lot more than that because here at New York One, we are in the unique position of often shooting our own stories. And we were sort of founded on that philosophy that reporters go out and we're actually the photographer, the camera person, the producer, the reporter, all in one. So it's a very involved day, but on the other hand, we have a lot more creative control, which enables us, I think, to tell a much better story than you're likely to see at the other stations in the city.
Which part of your job would you say you enjoy the most? Getting out there with the camera and being on the street or sitting at the anchor desk?
When I was interviewed for the job, I was asked, what do you want to do here? And I said my ideal job, not expecting to get it, of course, but my ideal job would be to work as an anchor, perhaps on the weekends, and to report the rest of the time, 3 days a week. I get bored doing one or the other, and there's a great deal of fulfillment from being able to tell your own story out in the field. On the other hand, it's such hard work that I'm grateful for the little bit of the break in being able to sit down at an anchor desk and tell the news from there. Although that doesn't minimize the energy or the expenditure of energy that goes into anchoring, because that too is a lot of hard work.
Curious how much anchoring or reporting you did prior to New York One. What background do you have coming here?
Well, my background in journalism started out at CBS as a secretary, of all things. I had come into that as, prior to that I was an actress, and I had just decided that was it. I was, you know, tired of the rat race. And ironically, the day I got the job at CBS, I was offered a movie role, and it was a very nice movie role. I would have had to go to Japan, and they would have spent a lot of money on me. But in any case, I made the commitment to the new job, and so I had to sacrifice my theatrical career. So I started out at CBS as the secretary, and then I sort of worked my way up as a writer and a producer, all the while really wanting to be on the air, which making that leap is quite difficult. So I had to leave New York City. Fortunately, I didn't have to go too far. I went to News 12, Long Island, which was sort of the pioneer in local 24-hour broadcasting.
Right.
And there I was able to start on the air and eventually work my way up to the anchor desk. But that's something you have to earn. I think a lot of young people go into this business expecting to become anchors right out of school. And it really isn't that way. I mean, to be an anchor, you have to have a real broad general knowledge of the business that you don't get unless you've been working at it for quite some time.
In many capacities.
In many capacities, yeah. So then from News, after working at News 12 for about 5 years, I was there when it started, I ended up getting the job here, and it's been wonderful.
I said you're a part of it, part of the team. Thank you very much, Roma.
My pleasure.
That wraps it up for today. And we'll be back again next month with another installment of Behind the Scenes at New York One.